So that works. Do you hear me? Okay. No, you don't hear me. Okay. So as Sandra says, I was here a couple of years ago for a little seminar, and I'm very happy to be back today. I'm very happy for two reasons, because I'm very happy to be here anyway, but also I'm very happy because I'm going to talk about a subject which I first put together the elements of this reflection I'm going to propose to you here, in fact, during this seminar. I remember very well this period because, sorry for these details, but I was a very young father at the moment. I just had a baby. And I remember this period as being a period of hallucination, very well known of young parents who doesn't sleep and everything. And I had promised, I had said I would give a lecture once on precisely landscape and memory. And I was exhausted by not sleeping every night and everything. And I wondered really what I was going to say this day. And so I mainly, one day, put together a few things like that. And in fact, I was very happy afterward to have put those things a bit like that. And it became a reflection. Peter Baird was there, I remember. It became something. It expanded into a little essay I recently published in this review, Le Visiteur. This is a bit of publicity for this review. In the last issue, I published something called The Art of Memory, Landscape Architecture and the Art of Memory. And that's mainly the subject I'd like to address tonight. So I'm going to come back with the same subject, plus, I hope, the interests of having fructified during two years. First, and this situation also, it explains why, the fact that I was a young father, it explains why talking about memory, I will also talk about childhood. I will say a few words in introduction to explain how this issue of memory is related and central to the question of suburbanism or suburban design. And this I will do by formulating as mere statements a few things that should be proved, but we won't have time for that, and maybe we can discuss these things during the seminar. To say things roughly, it strikes me that under the pressure of worldwide suburbanization, the field of activities and preoccupation that we designate with the word urbanism, or with such expressions as urban design or urban planning, is nowadays undergoing deep and radical change of focus. So deep, this change, so deep and so radical that it is not always very clearly perceived, even by urban planners themselves. Furthermore, this change of focus is masked by the word urbanism itself, the word which is etymologically rooted in the concept of city and the habits and models of city planning. This change of focus, we could resume it by saying that it mirrors, in a way, the revolution that has occurred in philosophy between the principle of hope formulated by Ernst Bloch at the mid-century and the principle of responsibility emphasized by Hans Jonas a few years ago. In the language of architecture, we could say that the concern for program has been replaced, or at least matched more and more, by the concern for sight. I think the great question, to put it in a few words like that, the great question of planning today is not that which preoccupied Alberti, for example, that is how to choose the site where the city will eventually be built, but rather how are we going to inherit and through which projects, sites, which are all concerned by suburbanization when they don't even have a strong past and hard past in this domain. So I propose the concept of suburbanism to name this new condition and this change of focus, which in my opinion has been best understood a few years ago, consciously or not, in the area of landscape architecture, and which certainly accounts for the presence more and more of landscape architects, landscape architecture in the foreground of the debates today. As this concept of suburbanism, at least in the sense which I give, which I understand, is a neologism, I have to propose a definition. So that would be my definition. Suburbanism is a design process or attitude particularly required in suburban areas, but not only, in which the hierarchy, which is traditionally established or assumed in urban planning between program and site, from the program to the site, from the inside to the outside, take the expression of Le Corbusier, where this hierarchy is hypothetically reversed, the site becoming the horizon of the project, or if you like, the subject, the substrate in which the program would have to be deciphered. I confess that this neologism, suburbanism, is not very elegant, not very easy to pronounce. In English, sorry, but in French it's horrible, really. But it has three advantages in my point of view. The first advantage is that it designates between city and countryside. This in between, this third element, which is nowadays the most common and current of the scenes in which we live, and which is certainly the most current among the places where we work as architects and landscape architects. That's the first advantage. The second one is that it questions the concept of urbanism, other neologism, which is not much more than one century old. And third advantage, last but not the least, it points out towards the substrate of any project, that is to the site or to the place or the landscape, as being the real infrastructure whose sense is engaged by any project. That's one of the reasons why the title of the review, which is not a landscape review only, but architecture and landscape, is named Le Visiteur. I think that the world today must be visited, that must be named, we must invent new ways of representing it. Okay. Now, trying to evidence the peculiarity of this design process or attitude, it seems to me I have put forward a long time ago four characteristic reflexes which are rooted in the tradition of garden and which seem to me characteristic of this suburbanist attitude today.